Now on for a journey into the mind and psyche of ABC's Martin Fry, today's victim for Startest.
Hello, Martin.
Hello there.
Welcome to Startest, the computer interview. Please just relax and enjoy yourself.
My name's Martin Fry, a group called ABC. We've been making records now for a number of years, and we'll be making records for a number of years to come.
Here are 9 categories of questions. Please select a category by simply touching the screen.
Power and glory, please.
Please choose any number.
13.
Are you a follower or a leader?
I was a sixer when I was in the Boy Scouts, so that means I'm a leader, I suppose. A leader of men. I'm a leader. Number 12.
What is the thing that you most fear during a performance?
That moment when your mind blanks out and all you can think about are mundane everyday things like, you know, did you clean your shoes or do you need to buy some toothpaste? And when you're performing on stage, that moment when you, for a slight instant, you get bored and then you like, you just drift off mentally. And the scariest thing is you can still do everything physically and sing and move around and everything. But your mind has wandered off. I don't really enjoy that much when it happens, which is rare. Number 11.
Who has been the most influential person in your life?
I'd say my mum, Barbara, and my dad, Walter, and my wife, Julie, Mark White in ABC. All of those people have influenced me in different ways, very different ways. You know, influenced me to a point where I am what I am now, you know. Number 10.
How much do you owe your fans?
I don't think I owe anybody anything. And that's because I don't really think that anybody owes me anything. I've never thought that I've got any laurels to rest on. Or that ABC can make a record and, you know, 300,000 people are gonna naturally walk out and buy it. Every record we make is like the first record to us. We've got to go out there and find people and interest people in what we do. So, from that way of thinking, I kind of feel that I don't owe anybody anything. It's like, that's how I look at it. Number 15.
How strong is your willpower?
It's weak. It really is. It's not strong at all. Otherwise, I would have given up smoking cigarettes years ago. Yeah. Occasionally it's strong. Occasionally my willpower flexes its muscles, but day to day it tends to be pretty weak. Number 9.
What has been your most glorious failure?
I once had a perm. That was a glorious failure. Yeah, I had this really long hair in about 84, I think it was, and I wanted to change drastically. So I, had this sort of corkscrew perm, and it was okay for about 35 minutes, and then I started to look like Robert Plant from Led Zeppelin like this. That was like a magnificent failure. That was great. Yeah, 16.
You are a Dalek. Who do you exterminate?
The Cybermen. think. Or Doctor Who. I don't like the new Doctor Who very much. I'd blow his head off straight away. Yeah, Doctor Who. I'd go get him sorted out, no problem. Number six.
Who would you stand next to in the Hall of Fame?
Ooh. Who would I like to stand next to? I guess Elvis Presley. I'd like to see how tall he was. Or William Shakespeare.
Which is your favourite club?
The Hacienda in Manchester.
Do you prefer rhubarb or pineapple?
Pineapple.
When did you last have a haircut?
I last had a haircut when? About 2 weeks ago at Vidal Sassoon's in London.
Were you breastfed?
I think I was, yeah. I'd have to ask my mum about that. I can't remember that far back. Yeah, I think I was.
Who is your favourite designer?
Nick Coleman.
Who is your favourite film director?
David Lynch.
Which is your favourite TV programme?
Coronation Street, without a doubt.
What car do you drive?
A BMW 320i, two-door.
Which is your favourite pop group?
Kraftwerk, yeah.
Which is your favourite city?
London.
Lullabies and melodies reveal. In deep despair on lonely nights, he knows just how you feel. The slyest rhymes, the sharpest suits, and miracles made real. Like a bird in flight on a hot, sweet night, you know you're right, just hold your tight. He suits it right, makes it out of sight, and everything's good in the world tonight. When smoke ascends, I hear violins. When smoke ascends, I forget everything. As she's packing the things, as she's spreading the wings, the front door might slam, but the back door it rings. And smoke ascends.
Now please select a new category.
Sweet and sour, please. What's that all about? Sweet and sour.
Please choose any number.
Number 10, please.
How easy do you find it to laugh at yourself?
I laugh at myself quite a lot, yeah. I'm not really that pompous. I think it's essential as well. I think the day you lose your sense of humour, you lose your mind. Mm. 13.
How do you look in drag?
I don't know, really. I've never had the urge to slide on the silk stockings. I wouldn't mind looking like, what's that TV show? With Bruce Willis. I wouldn't mind looking like his opposite in that TV show. What's that show called? Yeah, I wouldn't mind looking like Faye Dunaway in drag. We're both blondes. 14.
Which is your best physical feature?
My right foot. My right foot's pretty, used to be pretty good with a football. My brain. Number 11.
Who is your best friend?
Julie Fry, my wife. Number 4.
Would you rather write great fiction and be poor, or trash and be rich?
Great fiction and be rich, yeah, definitely. There's a lot of trash that's great fiction, ain't there, really? There's a lot of supposedly great fiction that is rubbish. But, yeah, I'd go for the blockbuster, definitely, if I was sitting at a typewriter. I'd go for them. Well, I want to be paid in my lifetime, do you know what I mean? A lot of these writers, you know, 400 years later, somebody assumes they're worth merit, and therefore they make a lot of dough, but they can't spend it because they're dead. So trash, yeah. Number five.
Are you moody? Are you moody?
Yeah, I can be moody. I tend to sort of oscillate, is that the right word? So when I'm happy, I'm very happy. And when I'm down, I can get, you know, very down for a little while. But I don't really stay moody for very long. Usually the first 15 minutes, when I get up in the morning, what I call the early morning snide, that is when I'm at my moodiest.
Now please select a new category.
Faith and fortune, please. There we go.
Please choose any number.
7, please.
How optimistic are you about the future of the world?
I'm an optimistic kind of fella, but the world looks a bit sticky at the moment, doesn't it? It depends how much of the ozone layer's left in the future and how many, you know, it's all, I think the world's gonna be here for a good while to come, but I think Homo sapiens are gonna have to do something about its longevity. Number 6.
Have you ever been to a fortune teller?
I daren't go to a fortune teller because I like the future to be as a surprise, as much of a surprise as it can be. So, and I think I believe in like psychics and stuff, but won't admit to it. So I'm reticent about going to see a fortune teller in case I find out something I might not want to hear. Number 9.
What is your vision of heaven?
I think heaven, if it exists, is somewhere very silent, with a blue sky and white sand, somewhere pretty idyllic. I think heaven's the kind of place where you can just spend a lot of time with all your friends. I don't know. I think heaven, heaven, it would be a tropical island. Number 5.
Which do you trust in more, your mind or your heart?
My mind or my heart? You shouldn't really trust your heart, you know, because it can be fairly erratic where making judgments is concerned. Then again, so can your mind, so I trust neither, really. Trust intuition. Intuition. Number 10.
If you were a ghost, who would you haunt?
I'd be like the ghosts in Beetlejuice. I'd haunt the people that moved into my house after I died. I'd get them out fast. With a lot of psychic behavior. You know, moving furniture around, stuff like that. And if that didn't work, I'd take it a stage further. Number 8.
Name 3 great things about being you.
I don't know, really. I'm 6'2". That's a pretty good thing when you're when you need to see over people's heads. But it's not a great thing when you've got to climb under things. So that ain't bad, being tall. And I'm fairly modest. So modesty is a virtue. And since I'm modest, I can't give you a third great thing about myself. I'm too modest to give it you.
Now please select a new category.
Bread and butter, please.
Please choose any number.
Number 2, please.
Are you well paid for what you do?
Yeah, very well paid. Overpaid. If things go well, you know, if you have a hit record, you're vastly overpaid. But then again, you spend a lot of time doing stuff for nothing, so, yeah. I I can't complain. It's more than what I used to get at the garden centre where I used to work there when I first started work. 25 pence an hour. I get more than that. Number six.
How materialistic are you?
Everything I own wouldn't fit in a rucksack. But if it all, you know, collapsed and disappeared tomorrow, I don't think I'd shed too many tears. So I don't think I am mega, mega yuppie materialistic. I think too many people are these days. I think what's going on inside your head's more important than, you know, what you're carrying around on your back or, you know, what kind of trinkets you've got in your home. Number three.
What is your most valuable possession?
My health. Yeah. Number four.
Do you see your bank manager as friend or foe?
Well, I see him as a friend. I have to when I go in and beg him for an overdraft on Westbourne Grove, NatWest. So, he's pretty good. I don't see a lot of him. I don't spend a lot of time, you know, discussing the world of finance. Number five.
How large is your overdraft?
Well, if you'd asked me last week, it would have been pretty large, but I just got paid. I just got paid some dough. So, like, it ain't that big now. It doesn't exist now. There's a couple of bob in there. Number one.
How much are you worth?
I really don't know. I've no idea.
Please concentrate hard on answering the questions in this section truthfully. If you appear not to be telling the whole truth,
right,
you will forfeit the chance to show your video. From the five questions which follow, you may pass on just two.
Right.
What are Mark's irritating habits?
I'd say they were his steadfastness. He's stubborn. He believes what he thinks is correct. And that can be irritating, but it's also a strength.
Do ABC lack a consistent style?
No, I don't think we do. I think we tend to experiment a great deal and try different ideas out, both visually and orally. You know, it kind of... It might look schizophrenic from a distance, but I think there's a thread through most of the records we've made and the things we've done that is unmistakably ABC.
Are spots still a problem?
Pass.
Which personal qualities helped you fight cancer?
Just believing in yourself, you can achieve a great many things. Strength of will. Nobody fights cancer alone. Modern medicine, science. Dr. Christopher Best, my doctor, guys like that, people at the Royal Marsden, people in Sheffield. Radiotherapy, chemotherapy. I have to say, plus a little bit of me helping along the way, I suppose, but modern technology and science, that can conquer most things.
You now have 30 seconds to talk about your latest recording.
It's a funny thing, isn't it? But these days, rather than give you the hard sell, I'll just say the brand new record by ABC called Up features The Greatest Love of All and One Better World and The Real Thing and Where Is the Heaven and Paper Thin. I think it's our most confident record to date. It's better than everybody else's record, so if you feel by it. But if you don't, I won't feel too bad about it. There'll be more.
Selling guns.
Please select a new category.
Love and passion, please.
Please choose any number.
Number one, please.
What are your inhibitions?
Being British, I suppose I am pretty inhibited. I don't know. It's hard to answer that one. Very hard. I don't think I'd enjoy walking down Oxford Street naked, you know. I'm no Lady Godiva. So I guess that's one of my inhibitions. Number 12.
Did you send a card last Valentine's Day?
No. Didn't send any Valentine's Day cards. Number 11.
When did you last have sex in the open air?
Well, it's been a hot summer. Pretty recently, I suppose. Pretty recently. Next question, number 8.
What turns you on?
Your voice. Number 3.
Who was your first love?
I think probably Bobby Charlton, George Best, Willie Morgan, Nobby Stiles. I used to want to be those guys. Number 4.
Which are your erogenous zones?
I'd say they were here and here. Kind of all over.
Thank you for playing Star Test.
Thank you.
Have you enjoyed yourself?
Yeah, I have. It's a pleasant way to spend an afternoon.
Who would you like to see in the Star Test chair?
I'd say you'd be good. Alec Gilroy, or the actor that plays him. Or Bernard Manning. I don't know if you heard him. In pop music. I wonder who's good. A lot of people in pop music haven't got much to say for themselves, have they? So you should really have Margaret Thatcher, shouldn't you? That'd be good.
You are now invited to select 5 characteristics from the on-screen menu which you feel best illustrate your personality.
I'd say happy. My personality. Humorous. Modest. Stubborn. And kind. And eccentric.